everybody, Star here. What's up, everybody? I know you've all been Halloweening in TF2, but this is, like, sort of actual gameplay where you're not fighting other people to try and get fabulous prizes and to get onto Loot Island with all of that fun stuff. To be honest with you, I didn't really enjoy the Halloween stuff that much, but I can't honestly be cynical about a free update that happens once every year and does have some pretty crazy stuff within it. Just so many hats, so many hats released with this thing that you can only wear every once in a while is kind of outrageous. And that being said, once again, I can't possibly be cynical about free updates. Every time this happens, well, since the last time it happened with the Halloween update and the whole Headless Horseman thing, I always think, oh, Valve, you could have went so much bigger, and you could have made this whole new game mode all about killing monsters and getting loot and finding gifts. And then I'm like, oh, wait, I'm kind of glad you didn't go that far. This is not an RPG. Let's get back to actually playing the game. What's going on right here is I'm playing on King of the Hill Asheville using the scattergun. I've got the pistol as well, and I believe the holy mackerel, which I don't think I kill anyone with. As far as scout loadout goes, I probably would recommend in this type of situation, especially on Asheville, because it's so, you know, everyone's really clustered up together. Mad Milk is almost always the better option in servers where there's a lot of people derping around. The pistol does come in handy in a couple of battles, but Mad Milk in general helps out your teammates so much more. And Asheville. Asheville is still one of my favorite King of the Hill maps. There's always so much going on here. Where every time I post a gameplay on this map, it feels like it's a good one, no matter what, because there's so much action going around all over the map, constantly running around, shooting people and all that stuff. This one went really well. I'm doing all those things. I'm running around, shooting people, and all that stuff. But the end of the match doesn't go that well for us, and I immediately wanted to blame heavies. Where at the end of this match, it really felt like red team was pushing us back, and they started to win because they got an extra heavy, and their heavies were really pushing through, and they got medics for their heavies. And that definitely is an easy way to say, hey, we want to win this. We should get some heavies and some more power classes. So that is immediately was like, oh, but throughout this entire gameplay, every heavy I run into hasn't really been a problem. I immediately blame them, but at the same time, the heavies, I don't know, they weren't really that big of a deal. Every battle I get into one, it's just like, oh, no problem, heavy, I'll shoot him a couple times, he's dead, whatever. But we'll talk about that a little bit more when it becomes relevant and I can actually show you what I'm talking about. As for right now, I'm just sort of running around as scout, and I don't really know what to tell you about what I'm doing. I've posted a lot of scout gameplays, and I love showing them, but I also sort of have the dilemma of, I don't know what to talk about on scout gameplays anymore, for the reason that it feels like I've said everything already. And to a certain degree, what I'm doing is kind of mindless. It's just very basic. Run around to make sure you see someone when their back's turned, or someone you're confident that you can kill, then I go after them, I kill them. Depending on how much health I lost, I go for a health pack, rinse, repeat, and it does stay very action-packed on Asheville, not only because there are people everywhere, but also because there are so many health packs scattered throughout this map that you can rely on getting, especially as a scout. Just run over here really quickly, oh, there's a guy, kill him, no problem, got the health, and now I can go find somebody else to harass. Oh cool, there's medics here that don't see me yet, of course I'm gonna harass them. Not much really going on right here. I wish I would have followed up on that medic and tried to kill him with my pistol or something, but I jump up here, try and get as much damage on him as I possibly can, back off because I had no team support, but then the pyro goes in there and I kind of felt obligated to try and help him out, but backing off was the right first impression there. Here we are getting spawn camped. Guys, when you're getting spawn camped, I don't know if you know this, but you can actually change classes in your spawn room, and it lets you do that, like, for free. I tried to come out here to try and get at least the medic or something, but I was missing all my shots because I'm kind of bad. And so I just switched to heavy, no problem. You know, even if they deal damage to me, you can see as I'm fighting them, the closet, you know, gave me my health back. Not really a problem here. So just clear that up, we're all good. Spawn camping, not that effective as long as you be heavy, I guess. That's the moral of the story, be heavy. Now we're going to talk about being heavy. Because this is kind of the point of the match where I come out here and I start to see a lot of heavies. Cool, no problem. I killed that guy. The other one died too. No problem as for right now, but they come back later. They've got two of them at the moment. And really what the problem started to turn out to be was not the fact that they had two heavies, but for some reason my team wasn't Like, I don't see a single teammate push mid from the rest of this. From here to the end of the video, I don't see it happen, like, at all. They're cool, there's a spy there, that's not really gonna help me out at all. Actually, cool, you know what, we have some people on the point right now, not exactly yet, but we'd sort of get wiped out over here, get pushed back. The, we only need to capture it for about 40 more seconds, but then the medics, the heavies, show up on point, we get exploded, going to be respawning in a second, and like I said, it's not just the heavies' fault, because as I respawn, I think I even get to see the fact that we are getting attacked by crits and a whole bunch of other stuff, so my team definitely was getting stomped. And I don't want this to sound like, oh my god, my team, I couldn't win this, only my team is so bad. Scout is a class where you really do need to rely on teammates being distractions for you so you can try and get in and kill things. Right here is my desperate attempt to try and get on the point, get some capture time. There's 30 seconds left, and in these 30 seconds, I see no one. That heavy, once again, heavy's not a problem, but fighting a heavy with the mini sentry nearby and all these other people, like the engineer distracting me with no distractions for me to rely on myself, I can't get much done. So, inevitably, we lose this round. People try and get on the point over here, but there is still a heavy and still a mini sentry and just one scout trying to attack it again. Absolutely not going to work out that way. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. You see me try and rage demo to get there as quick as I could because would at least let me get the mini sentry, hopefully the heavy, but couldn't even really get out of spawn. Press the like button if you did enjoy this video, subscribe for more, and I'll catch you guys later.